Hello, UIC fans, and welcome to another edition of the Flames Weekly Update. I'm Sam Paniatovich. The men's basketball team dropped a home game Wednesday night against Oakland by a final score of 91-77. The Flames were paced by Paris Burns and Amon Fels with 20 and 19 points, respectively. The Flames then earned their first road win of the season Sunday afternoon with an 83-73 win at Detroit. UIC shot a season-best 58% from the field and made 12 three-pointers. Mark Brown had 22 points, and Jay Harris scored 15 of his 19 points in the second half. The Flames continue their three-game road trip on Thursday at Wright State. The women's basketball team held a 10-point lead at halftime, but Cleveland State rallied back for a 75-73 overtime victory Wednesday night at the UIC Pavilion. Ravonna Campbell had game highs of 26 points and 17 rebounds. The Flames then trailed Youngstown State by 12 at halftime Saturday, but mounted a second-half comeback to win in overtime, the final score 66-63. The Flames outscored Youngstown by 15 and held the Penguins to 19% shooting after the half. Campbell finished with 23 points and 15 boards for her sixth straight double-double. Terry Bender scored 12 points and grabbed a career-high 11 rebounds. The Flames are back home Wednesday to play host to Detroit. The softball team opened its season in Rosemont at the Total Control Sports Invitational. The Flames won 3 out of 5 games over the three-day event. Laura Swan drove in 5 runs, Tiana Mackmiller homered, and Laurie Mitchell had a team-high 7 hits and 6 stolen bases. Carissa Frazier was impressive in her 4 appearances on the mound. The freshman struck out 14 batters and only allowed 2 earned runs over 17 innings. The Flames are off next weekend before heading to California for the Santa Clara Bronco Classic. The swimming and diving programs outswam Cleveland State Friday en route to victories in both the men's and women's competition. Mike Reed and Tanner Alms both captured 2 victories for the men. On the women's side, Brianna Hines, Sophia Shalabi, Erica Martinez, and Claire Haggerty all won 2 events. The Flames return to action on February 25th when they compete in the Horizon League Championships. The men's gymnastics team competed in Minneapolis Saturday as the Flames finished with a season-best score against Minnesota and Nebraska. Jason Gatiss placed first in the all-around competition, and teammate Brett Vallon placed in second. Alex Dumstorf led the team on parallel bars, and Keith Cohn had a strong performance on vault. The Flames returned to action Saturday when they traveled to Philadelphia to take on Temple. The women's gymnastics team recorded a season-best score but fell to Western Michigan Sunday afternoon at the UIC Pavilion. Gabrielle May set a career best on vault and tied for first place on bars on her way to an all-around victory. Elsewhere, Emily Desicari and Nikki Woodruff set personal bests on the beam and all-around. The Flames travel to Ypsilanti to take on Eastern Michigan in a dual meet on Sunday. The men's tennis team took on Elmhurst College Friday afternoon, and the Flames swept the Blue Jays. Isaac Laveras and Christopher Cole won in straight sets at the first 2 single spots. Maurizio Fioli and Carl Hedstrom teamed up at the number 1 double spot and won 6-3. UIC welcomed Southern Illinois to the Hinsdale Racquet Club on Saturday. The track and field teams competed at both the ONU Invitational and Notre Dame's Mayo Invitational. Brittany Schwarz won the 800-meter run, Ellie Wilging was victorious in the 1-mile run, and Ariel Gibbs tied for first in the long jump. Tess Earhart impressed in the 5,000-meter run at the Mayo Invitational with a time just over 17 minutes. The Flames are back in action next weekend when they compete in the Chicagoland Championships. Stay tuned to UICFlames.com every Monday for the Flames Weekly Update, and make sure to check out the Flames official Twitter and Facebook pages for all the latest news and results from UIC Athletics. I'm Sam Paniatovich, and as always, go Flames!